Hello students, today we will talk about method of joints. We will learn how to apply method of joints to solve any problem of a truss. So let us take the first problem. Suppose we are given this truss and we are asked to find the forces in all the three members of the truss by using method of joints. So it means we have to find FAB, FAC, FBC. Now if you see this particular truss, in this truss two supports are given, and this is a pin support and this is a roller support. So the very first step to solve the problem is that we should draw the free body of this particular truss. So in the free body, what do you have to label? You have to label the reactions at the supports mentioned in the truss. So let us draw its free body first. So when you will draw the free body of that particular problem, you will have to show everything which was mentioned in the question, means this force, all the dimensions of the points. Then after that, you have to replace these supports by the constraints they offer. So this particular support will offer only two types of constraints. First constraint will be normal to its surface. Now let us see where is its surface. This is the surface. This is the surface. So to this surface, this will be the normal reaction. And second will be along the surface. So this is the surface. So second reaction will be along the surface. This is along the surface and this is normal to the surface. Similarly, roller support offers only one reaction, that is normal to the surface. So this is the surface of roller support. So normal to surface will be this direction. Fine. So if we have to draw the free body of this truss, we have to draw everything mentioned in the question and we have to replace these supports by the reactions they offer. Fine. So when you will do this, you will get this diagram. Now you see at A, one reaction is shown as normal to the surface. This was the surface of pin support. So to this surface, one is normal, another is along the surface. Now at roller support, this was the surface of roller support. To that surface, one reaction will be normal to the surface. So how to label these reactions? So the point mentioned for pin support is A. So we'll label reaction at A, RA, but actually this is horizontal direction or X direction. So we'll say X. Then this we will label as reaction at A in Y direction, because it is actually acting along vertical direction. Though this is along the surface of the pin support, but actual direction for this particular problem is vertical direction. So that is why we labeled it as Y. So this is X axis for us, this is Y axis for us. Now you see, we have assumed their direction. I have assumed the direction of this reaction towards left side, and I have assumed the direction of this reaction in downward direction. So similarly, at roller support, we have labeled the point mentioned for roller support is C. So we have labeled reaction at C, but the direction is X direction. So X, R, C, X. Now for this reaction also, we have assumed its direction. We don't know its direction. We just assumed that it is acting towards left side. Okay. So this is the first step. Draw the free body, label the reactions, identify the supports. Over here pin support was mentioned, so we added two reactions. Over here roller support was mentioned, so we added one reaction. So roller support offer reaction normal to the surface. This was the surface, so normal to the surface. This was the surface for pin support. One is normal to the surface, another is along the surface. So after this first step, we have to apply three equations. What are those three equations? We call those equations as equations of equilibrium. Summation fx is equal to 0. Then we say summation fy equal to 0. Then movement about any point is equal to 0. So these three equations we use to find the unknowns. So what are the unknowns at the start? Unknowns are the reactions. So there are three unknowns: RAY, RAX, RCX. So we will use these three equations to find these three unknowns. This is the second step. So what we will write? Find reactions RAX, RAY and RCX. So we will put a step A. What is that step? Summation fx is equal to 0. That means whatever forces which are acting in x direction in this truss, add those forces, equate those forces equal to 0. So let us see how many forces are acting in x direction. This is RAX acting along x direction. This is RCX acting along x direction. And third force is 84 kN, but it is not acting along x direction. Fourth force is RAY. This is also not acting along x direction. So there are only two forces which are acting along x direction: RAX, RCX. Now one more thing to understand, that we will make one assumption regarding their positive or negative sign. Any force which will act towards left side, we will assume that force negative. And any force which will act towards right side, we will take that as positive. Similarly, any force which will act in upward direction, we will take positive. Any force which will act in downward direction, we will take negative. Now you see, we have identified that in this particular problem, there are two forces acting in x direction. Both are acting towards left. It means we will add these two, but their sign will be negative. So that is why it is written minus RAX minus RCX is equal to 0. So from here we will get RAX plus RCX is equal to 0. This is a single equation, but both are unknowns. So can't solve. For time being, call this equation as equation number 1. Now apply the second equation, summation Fy equal to 0. So B part will be summation Fy equal to 0. That means whatever forces which are acting in vertical direction in this truss, add those forces, equate those forces equal to 0. So let us first see how many forces are acting in y direction. First force is 84 kN, second is RAY. Now both are acting in downward direction. So what we will do? We will add these two forces, but we will take their sign negative. So that is why it is mentioned here, minus RAY minus 84 equal to 0. So from here we will get RAY equal to minus 84 kN. It means we got the first answer, that is the answer for RAY, the first unknown. But one very important point to understand, for RAY we got a negative answer, minus. That means the assumption which we have taken for its direction, we assumed at the start that it is acting in downward direction, but for it we got negative sign during solution. It means this assumption is wrong. Actually RAY is acting in upward direction. So this direction, correct direction, you should keep in your mind when you will solve the next steps. Fine. So what you can do, you can label that correct direction next to the free body, so that this correct direction should be in your mind when you will solve the further steps. Now apply the third equation. What is third equation? Whatever forces are acting in the free body, take their moment about any particular point, add those moments and equate equal to 0. So try to pick that point or that moment center while taking the moments at which maximum forces are acting. Why we are doing this? Then our equation will become simple. Let me tell you how. Suppose in step C we have taken that moment summation m about A is equal to 0. Now if you take moment about A, what will happen? At A, two forces are acting. So their perpendicular distance from A is 0. It means when you will make this equation, you will get rid of these two forces directly. It means your equation will be simple, will have less variables. So that is why I said choose that point to take the moments, take the moment at which maximum forces are acting. So moment about A equal to 0. So moment because of these two forces is 0. So we are left with only two forces in the system. One is RCX, another is 84 kN. So let us first take moment because of 84 kN about point A. Now this will generate anti-clockwise movement. So anti-clockwise movements we consider positive, fine. One thing to understand, if we are finding the movements of the forces, we don't focus on the direction of the forces. We only focus what type of movements they generate. If those forces generate anti-clockwise movements, we take positive sign. If those forces generate clockwise movements, we take negative sign. Now you see this particular force, its arrowhead is in downward direction. So we are not concerned about its direction, but it will try to move towards movement center. So the closest path is this path. So it will generate anti-clockwise movement. So anti-clockwise movement will take positive. So what is the formula? Its magnitude into its distance, perpendicular distance from movement center, that is A. Okay, so that is why we are here written positive 84 into what is the perpendicular distance? This is the force and this is the movement center. So what is the perpendicular distance between these two? It is 3 meters mentioned in the problem. So into 3. Next is RCX. So let us see what type of movement it will generate, anti-clockwise or clockwise. Now you see the direction is towards left. We are not concerned about its direction, but we will see what type of movement it will generate. Now the closest path, the shortest path is this path. So it will generate what? Clockwise movement. Clockwise movement means negative movement. So see over here, minus is written, minus RCX into what is its perpendicular distance? Its line of action is this and movement center is here. So what is the perpendicular distance between movement center and line of action? It is 4 plus 1.25. So that is 5.25 equal to 0. In this equation, there is only one variable. So we will calculate that variable from this equation. So RCX will be equal to 48 kilonewton. Now one thing to understand, we got positive value for RCX. It means our assumption which we took at the start for RCX, that was towards left, is correct. So no need to change this. Now we will say, put this value in equation number 1 to get value of RAX. So when you will put this equation in equation number 1, you will get value of RAX, that is RAX equal to minus 48 kilo Newton. Now see, for RAX, we got negative sign. It means the assumption which we took at the start for RAX, we took towards left. So that is wrong. It means its correct direction is towards right side. So you can label correct direction on the free body just for the reference of further steps. So this was the second step, that find all the unknowns, that is unknown reactions, by using these three equations. Now the next step. Next step is we have to find the forces in these three members. The first member is FAB, second member is FAC, third member is FBC. Now for that we have to see how many total joints are there. In this particular truss there are three joints, joint 1, joint 2, joint 3. So rule says we have to start with only that joint where maximum unknown forces are 2, fine. So if I pick joint A, to this joint A, there are two members connected. One is member AB, second is member AC. Apart from these two members, on this joint, there are two reactions acting. Now, for these two reactions, we have just calculated their values. It means these two reactions are known values, but the forces in member AB and member AC are unknown. So, at joint A, maximum unknowns are 2, that is FAB, FAC. It means according to rule, we can start our step with joint A. Fine, but let us consider other joints as well. If I focus on joint C, there are two members connected, BC, AC. So in these two members, forces are unknown. At joint C, one reaction is also acting. But for this reaction, we have already found its value. It means this is a known value. At C, maximum unknowns are 2. So we can start with C as well. Fine. It's now, there is a choice. Either you can start with A or C. Similar situation is there for B as well. For B, maximum unknowns are 2. Third value is known to us. So it means what we have concluded, we can start with any joint for this particular truss given. So let's see with which joint we have started. We have started with the joint A. So next up we will say equilibrium of joint A. Fine. Now there is one very important point to understand. When we have to start the next step, we have to draw the free body of that joint. Now let us understand how to draw the free body. Now suppose we have to start with joint A. So we have written equilibrium at joint A. So what is the correct way to draw the free body? First of all, make the joint, mark the joint. So what is the name of that joint? A. So call that joint A. Then you should see how many members are connected. There are two members connected, AB, AC. AC is acting in downward direction. So label that member first in vertical direction, downward direction. Then label the second member. It is acting at some angle to the horizontal. So show the same angle, approximate angle here in the free body as well. Now the next thing to label is that these two members have forces which are unknown to us. So label those forces first. Always label those forces away from the joint. Now this is the joint, so label the force away from the joint. So if you label any force away from the joint, that force will be called as tensile force. Fine. So we will label it as force AB, FAB, because the name of the member is AB. Now similarly in this member as well, label force away from the joint. So away is this direction, away from the joint. So this is F, it is in member AC. Fine. So this is also tensile because we have considered it away from the joint. So after this you should see, is there any reaction acting at A? Yes, there are two reactions acting at A. Fine. So let us label first reaction Rax, but its correct direction is this, which we have concluded while solving the values for these reactions. So don't label this direction now, label the actual direction. So it is acting towards right in horizontal direction. Similarly for Rax, don't label the assumed direction, label the correct direction. It is acting in upward direction, that is vertically upward. After that, first label these values. We have found Rax as 48. Over here minus 48 is written, Rx minus 48, but we have already reversed its direction. Fine. So mention only 48, don't mention negative sign. This is a very important point to understand because we have already reversed its direction. Now for Ray, we have calculated value minus 84, but we have already reversed its direction. So don't put minus, just label 84. So this is very important part to understand. After this, you should see, is there any external force acting at joint A? No, there is no other external force acting at joint A. It means these are the only forces acting at joint A. So after labeling these forces, what is the next step? Next step is we should show the components of those forces which are acting at some angle to the horizontal or to the vertical. So in this particular free body, only one force is there which is acting at some angle. So we have to find its components. So how to find the components? This force is acting at joint A. So at A, show one horizontal dashed line and extend this member with vertical dashed line. Now this particular force, arrowhead, is marked away from the joint. So in this dash line also mark away from the joint, away from the joint. Then after this, what we will do? We have to find its angle either with vertical or with horizontal. It's your choice. So let us find its angle with horizontal, theta. So if we have taken theta with this axis, so this axis will become cos axis, this axis will become sine axis. So we will label this as F A B cos theta. So we will label this as F a b sine theta. So now with this we are ready with the free body, but what unknown value we have to calculate first? Theta. So we have to first find theta. Fine. So you see the same free body is shown here. So this free body, in this free body the members, the components of FAB are also added. So first thing is to find theta. So how to find theta? For that we have to take the help of the truss. So angle theta is this angle theta. So how to find that theta? We will assume this triangle A, B, let us say this point is D. Fine. So we can say in triangle ABD theta will be, tan theta will be, what will be tan theta? Perpendicular upon base. So how much is the perpendicular? 1.25. Base is how much? Base is 3. So over here theta will be tan inverse 1.25 by 3. So from here we will get the value of theta, that will be 22.61. So put that value here. So accordingly we will put that value in cos and sine. After drawing the free body of joint A, we will apply two equations to every joint. So what will be those two equations? Summation fx is equal to 0, summation fy equal to 0. Now this is the very important part to understand. When we were calculating for reactions raxy, ray and rcx, then in that case we can apply these three equations. But when you are solving an individual joint, then only two equations are applicable to that joint. So let us apply first equation, summation fx, to this particular free body. Fine. So it means we have to look for those forces which are acting in horizontal direction. We have to add those forces, then we have to equate those forces equal to 0. Forces acting towards right we will taken as positive, forces acting towards left will be taken as negative. Now in this whole free body there are only two forces acting in x direction. RAx, it is acting towards right, positive. FAB cos 22.61, it is acting towards left, taken as negative. So it means our equation will become summation fx is equal to 0. So equation will be minus FAB cos 22.61 plus 48. So you see 48 is taken as positive, and this is negative because it is acting towards left. So when you will solve this, from here you will get value of AB. FAB is 52 kilonewton. Now there is one important part to understand. At the start, we took the direction of AB away from the joint because we were not aware about its direction. We have just assumed away from the joint, tensile force. But when you calculated its value, you got a positive sign. That means the assumption which we took at the start is correct. So no need to reverse it. It means it is a tensile force. We got our first answer. Now what is the next step? To the same free body, we will apply what? Second equation, summation fy equal to 0. So how many forces are acting in y direction? There will be three forces. FAC, FAB sine theta, 84. Forces acting in our direction will be positive. Forces acting in downward direction will be taken as negative. So that's why in the equation it is written as 84 positive minus FAC minus FAB sine 22.61 equal to 0. So from here you will see that there are two variables, but AB we have already found in the first step. So put that value 52 in this particular equation, then you will be able to find this variable FAC. So next answer is FAC 64 kilonewton. Now it is again positive. That means direction which we have assumed for AC in downward direction is correct. No need to reverse it. So it is also a tensile force. We got our second answer. So after this, what do you need to do? We started with the joint A and we have found forces FAB and FAC. Now rule says that you have to pick next immediate joint. In this case, next immediate joint is joint B. If I take this member, next immediate joint is C. So either you can start with C or you can start with B. But again, first rule will be applicable that pick that immediate joint first where maximum forces, maximum unknowns are 2. But at the start, we have already found that for these two joints, maximum unknowns are 2 only. Fine. So you can start with any joint next. Either you can consider equilibrium of joint B or you can consider equilibrium of joint C. So let us see what we have taken. We have taken equilibrium of joint C. So that means we started with this particular joint. It means what will be the next step? Next step will be again draw the free body of this particular joint. So let us learn how to draw free body of the joint again. So what is the first step? Label the joint. So mark a dot, call that, name that dot C. Then you should see how many members are connected. There are two members connected. So label first member, it is acting in vertical direction. Label second member, it is acting at some angle. Now, then you should see in which member has unknown force. Now, in this member, we have already found the force, FAC. So for that member, we will discuss later. First of all, label the force in that member, which is unknown to us. So this still we have to calculate BC. Fine. So in this member, label the force direction will be away from joint. That means we are considering again tensile force. This should keep in your mind. So for unknown member, consider away from the joint. But in this member, we have already found the force. And for direction of force for that member, we have to refer the previous free body. Which is a very important part to understand. This is the previous free body, that is joint A. In joint A, we assumed direction of AC in downward direction. And when we found its value was positive. That means our assumption is correct. But when you have to use this AC in next free body, that is for joint C, then you have to reverse its direction. So it means in the free body of joint C, its direction will be in upward direction. So this you should keep in your mind. Why this is so? See, FAC will act as a force acting at joint C. So this is joint C. So this is active force on joint C. This joint will offer reactive force against that action, Newton's third law. So that reactive force will be taken in the free body of C. So that is why in free body of C, we have reversed the direction of FAC. I hope this particular step is clear to you. And this is the most important step when we draw free body of the next immediate joint. So after this, let us see what other things we have to mention in the free body. So we were talking about joint C. So we have labeled two members. We have labeled the forces in these two members. One was unknown, one was known. After that, you should see how many reactions are acting at C. There is one reaction. So label that reaction. And its direction we have assumed towards left. And we got positive sign for this during calculation. So we will consider same direction in this free body also. So towards left. So let us label these. So this will be RCX. This will be FAC. And we have already calculated its value. What value we have calculated? Its value is 64 kilonewtons. So let us call this as 64. Then what is the force? FBC. Let us call it as FBC or AC. It's your choice. Let us call it as FCB towards this side. Fine. So it is unknown value to us. Then you should see any other external force acting at C. There is no other external force acting at C. It means these are the only forces acting at C. So what is the next step? Resolve the inclined forces into their components. So we have to resolve this into its components. So from C, draw a dashed line along X direction and extend this member with a dashed line in Y direction. Now this particular arrowhead is away from the joint. So consider direction away from the joint. Consider direction away from the joint. Now what is the next thing to see? We have to consider angle. So it's your choice. Either you can consider this angle or this angle. So let us consider this angle. Let us call this as theta. So we have taken angle of this force with this axis. So this will be cos component and this will be sine component. So it means this will become FCB cos theta. So this will become FCB sin theta. It means in order to solve this free body, what is the first step? First find theta. Fine. So how to find theta? Again come to the diagram. So this is theta which we have to find. Same theta. Fine. So how to find this theta? So we can assume a triangle. Which triangle? If I sketch a vertical line here, we can assume this triangle. So again, we can use tan theta. Fine. So if I have to apply tan theta to this particular triangle, that will be perpendicular. Perpendicular is 3 upon base. What is base? 4. So you see in the calculation what we have written, theta is equal to tan theta equal to 3/4. So theta will be equal to this angle. Now again, if I want to solve this free body, I have two choices. Means I have two options. I will use summation fx is equal to 0, summation fy equal to 0. Let us use first equation, summation fx is equal to 0. So for this equation, what we will see? Whatever forces which are acting in x direction, add those forces, equate those forces equal to 0. So how many forces are acting in x direction? There are only two, 48 and FCB sine 36.86. Both are acting towards left, so both will be taken as negative. So that is why it is written minus 48 minus FCB sine 36.86 equal to 0. So when you will solve this equation, you will get value of FCB. Now you see from the first equation only, we are able to find our variable. So there is no need to apply the next equation. So I hope the procedure of this particular numerical is clear to you. The same procedure is applicable to all the problems of truss where you have to apply method of joints. So see this video carefully, each part of the video, each step of the numerical carefully, then you will be able to solve any numerical related to trusses, related to method of joints. Thank you very much.